by Aki Kareem for BBTV over here at Hatton's Gym in Hyde. I've got young prospect Brett McGinty with me, who is a new addition to the camp. Firstly, Brett, tell us a little bit about yourself, man. Tell us your age, where you're from, the basics.
Brett McGinty, 21, just turned pro there. Over at Hatton now, looking forward to getting everything started. From Donegal, boxing, Oakleaf and Derry, so kind of a bit best of both worlds there. But now I'm looking forward to getting started now, first session today, since I'm officially turned, so ready to rock.
As I understand it, you were off the plane this morning and you're ready to go already in the afternoon, so that's a good sign of commitment.
That's kind of the way we have it set up now, that I'll get an early flight on a Monday morning. They don't start until 1 o'clock on a Monday with the rest of the lads travelling, so it suits me as well. I'll be able to fly in on a Monday morning. Not every week I'll be going home, but hopefully I get home most weekends and then get in early Monday morning, get a good 5 days of hard training, and then get home for a couple of days to get refueled and back in for another week's training, I suppose.
So you're staying in the famous house, are you? Ricky's house around the corner. A lot of the fighters got in. How are we settled in there?
Grand. I spent a few days in the summer over here as well. 5 days with Connor and Joe and them lads. So I knew what to expect when I was coming over. But I have to say, like, it's a good environment. You're around lads that are on the same boat as you, dieting, making weight, training hard, looking to better themselves. So it's suits me. I'm happy with everything. I'm happy with the setup. So I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, and in this gym you've got all different levels, from prospects through to the more established fighters. So you're going to get to watch them, and there's some great sparring that happens in here as well. And a lot of fighters travel here. Yeah. So you're going to get to be around lots of people in the fight game anyway, aren't you?
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's a good environment. The house is a good environment. The gym's, you know, there's top fighters coming in and out here every day. You're training along with them. So hopefully being against some of them and sparring them, whatever. It's a good environment all around. It's a good place to be bettering yourself. Good opportunity. It's all I could ask for whenever I was turning pro, for a good opportunity to push on and to make something of myself, and I have that now, so it's up to me to put the work on, I suppose.
And as I understand it, you were a Ricky Hatton fan, and that possibly is what provoked you to sort of get in contact with the gym.
Yeah, I think there's not many people that weren't a Ricky Hatton fan, but a lot of the Irish remember him from when he fought Eamon McGee.
That's right, yeah.
So, I know he had a bit of a scare earlier on against him and he dropped him, but he came back, he won the fight well. So I suppose that's where he got a lot of his interest, from the Irish people that came. He came and fought Eamon, so ever since then. But I suppose he was kind of like a character, you know, he was sort of a fighter for the people. He kind of related to the people, and he was, you know, he had a bit of character, a bit of humour with him. So I suppose there's not too many people that weren't a Ricky Hatton fan, but I was definitely one myself.
And you're going to have a bit of character and a bit of banter in this gym, because there's always a prank round the corner. Looking forward to that aspect of it.
I know what to expect, so I know what's coming my way, so I'll need to be lighthearted anyway.
Yeah, yeah. Because you haven't met some of the, have you met Blaney and Bradbury and all those guys as well?
No, I haven't actually. I've met Brad, but I haven't met Chris, although Chris is another Irish man.
Yeah.
But I haven't met him yet, but I'm sure I will this week at some stage.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, good. And I understand you've had a very good amateur career as well. Can you tell us a little bit about that, your pedigree and your background?
I was fairly successful in amateurs. I won 8 national titles. I won a European bronze, and I won a box for Northern Ireland in the Commonwealth Youth Games. I won a silver medal. So been unlucky a few times in the elite finals. Like, I've lost twice in the finals, once in welterweight and once in middleweight. So I've thought about staying for another year, but whenever I started boxing, like, the Olympics was never a big dream of mine. It was always to be world champion in the professional game. So instead of waiting about for another year and maybe one and maybe not, because the elites is a very high standard, I just decided that now was the right time to turn pro, and everything's worked out well so far for me, so looking forward to it.
Now, I've not seen you box yet, but just from watching you on the bags and stuff, you know, you throw the left hook like Golovkin, by the way you turn it over, but you seem to me like you might be a come forward fighter who likes to get in the mix. But I mean, tell me, would that be accurate to say from your style?
Definitely an aggressive fighter. That's the way I've fought all throughout the amateurs. One thing I do think, that the more rounds will suit me, because 3 rounds a lot of the time wasn't enough. You know, I'm notoriously a slow starter. I've often lost the first round and then came on strong. So I think the more rounds in the pro game will suit me. I'll be able to slow myself down. I'll not have to rush everything so much, and I'll not be chasing and that we have to chase people, they go looking for them, try and pin them down. People will be coming to fight. So, I've a great opportunity, and I definitely do think the pro game will suit me, especially the extra rounds. And I'm an aggressive fighter, so a lot of people have told me since I was a young age that you're made for the pro game. So it's up to me to prove them right now.
And what weight will you be turning over at?
Light middle.
Light middle, right, okay.
I was at welterweight, 69 for years in the amateurs, for 4 years, and then I was struggling to fight, the weigh in the morning and then fight in the evening, that's how it works. But so I moved up to middleweight last year, but I was making middleweight pretty easy, like, so I was never really a middleweight. I never really a fully blown middleweight, so the plan is to move down to light middle and take it from there.
Brilliant. And when could we see this pro debut? I mean, is there something in the pipeline, or are we just looking and waiting for dates and things?
It sort of depends on how I'm getting on. I know Shear Sports, that's who I'm signed with. They'll be in contact with Ricky. They're based in LA, so there's a bit of communication that'll need to be done there. But the plan is to be out before Christmas, like. So as long as everything's going to plan, I'm training right, I'm eating right, the weights, everything's going right. If Ricky, Mike, and Blaine, they're happy, then should be out before Christmas.
All right, man. Well, very much looking forward to seeing how this journey goes. Good to meet you today. And I'll see you again soon. Appreciate your time, mate. Cheers.
Thank you.